Hello and welcome to Dice Quest. My name is Jack, I am your Dungeon Master, and we have a special surprise for you today. Today, and for the foreseeable future, we have background music. This music was made by an amazing person named Circletone over on Fiverr.com. So, huge thanks to them, and enjoy.
Okay, go up to Marilyn, tap her on the shoulder, and be like, we leave at sunset. We leave tonight. We need to be at the docks by sunset.
Well, what time is it now?
What time is it now? Relative to the sun.
Are you asking me, or are you asking Maeve?
Yes.
Sure, I'll ask Maeve.
She kind of, like, looks out of a window.
Let's
see. What time did you guys got up? Probably, like, 2 hours ago. Probably about 10.
So we have about 12. Wait, no.
No.
We do not have 12 hours.
Good. Sunset's at 6 o'clock. It's not summer in Midwest United States. Or just Western.
You guys have probably about 6 hours of good sunlight.
Cool. So we have about 6 hours for...
I mean, I say good sunlight, but it's blizzard.
I have a quick question.
Mm.
Is it like Alaska here, where you get times where it's like straight day, and times where it's like straight night?
This is very far north.
Okay, so this is like, okay.
Yeah.
Also, we're in the middle of a blizzard raining.
Yeah, I know.
It's kind of at one of those points where like the day is super short, but you still get daylight.
So sunset is not far.
No.
Sunset's you guys have, like in an hour or two.
You guys have like 5 hours left of sunlight.
Okay.
It's not like super short, but it is noticeably shorter than the night.
Yeah.
Alright.
Cool.
Well, I don't think finding a bow in the middle of a snowstorm is going to be awesome. So, we could just wait till we get to Snowcastle and buy some shit there.
They'll probably have a better bow than
Snowcastle.
Right.
Probably. Unless he did some magic bows or something. Did he do magic bows?
Who are you asking?
You.
Me? You're not sure.
Probably not.
Well, he was an elf.
We'll probably find, like, nice bows. Like, you probably won't find a magic bow for cheap. Like, it'll probably be expensive. But, like, if you want to just find a normal bow, it'll probably be, like, pretty good in Snowcastle. Is in this world, is, like, castle-forged steel a lot better than steel you'd find in, like, a small town?
Yes.
So, like, if you bought a dagger at, like, Snowcastle, where it's castle forged, it would be a lot better.
If you go to the right shops. The main thing is, like, where it was forged.
Got it.
Because, like, some shops do their own forging. Like, here, the forge and the shop are one and the same.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, in a larger town, there's probably one forge that has probably about 6 or 7 workers that forge throughout the day, and they give to, like, 6 or 7 different shops.
Got it.
Sounds good.
Bless you.
Cool. I'm yawning, my dude.
Alright, what are we doing?
I'm down to take a nap. I don't know. Let's think. Well, what can we do within 5 hours? I guess we could try and go search for Lyra, but if she's in the forest...
Lyra? She's in the Grey Forest. Maybe.
In the middle of a blizzard, though.
I mean, the Grey Forest is pretty far... Well, I mean, she knows how to, like, get shelter in the Grey Forest. But the Grey Forest is pretty far away, right?
Yeah. It would take a couple days to walk, too.
She's probably not walking to the Grey Forest in this weather.
But no one's seen her is the problem.
She might be gone.
You're just hoping to get a girlfriend.
I thought Lyra was
somebody loved me.
Well,
not only that, but some of her skills are useful.
Well, yeah.
She knew some shit.
She was good at shooty,
nature.
Shooty shoots.
And sneaky sneaky. nature.
As what rangers do.
Oh, and
magic.
I can see you through the pop filter. It's very nice.
I'm going to assume that the last time we saw her was at the bonfire. That we were all like, oh, fuck it, it's cold. And we went inside. And then we just never saw her again. Which is sad, because she should have been like, oh, Well, I'm leaving. Bye.
You assholes.
Well, I mean, Laya just kind of was with us to do the camp thing. She actually has no, like, correlation to the Divine Village. I want to go talk to the Divine Village.
That's right, you do. I want to go to the library.
There is
in
no library.
Snowcastle?
Yeah, in Snowcastle.
There are a lot of libraries in Snowcastle.
Sweet.
And you just want to go steal some shit.
Yeah, I do want to go
Snowcastle.
Steal some shit.
It's tempting.
You know what?
Are we just kind of passing time, like fast forwarding to
sure, yeah.
Sure,
sunset?
Yeah.
Do you want to try to find a scabbard for your greatsword at all?
Oh,
because
yes.
I was editing last night and I was like, oh, he wanted a scabbard.
If we
try
had
to remember
more
that.
Time. I would actually get, like, a nice scabbard, but I think I'm going to wait till we go to Snowcastle.
Okay.
I'm going to go to you.
Do you want
to
get, like, a temporary one for right now?
Yeah,
or...
I was just going to get, like, some furs to wrap it.
Okay.
Just so, like, the blade doesn't get damaged, and when we get to, like, an actual place, I'll actually invest.
Yeah,
because
about
like,
the
a
sword
is going to
be damaged.
Well, I also want to get, like, a well-forged scabbard, so, like, if I leave the sword on and sheath it, it doesn't light the fur on fire. And instead it's just, like... And also, it's clean.
Alright.
I am going to go up to Marilyn and be like, can I borrow some gold?
How much gold?
Can I do like 5 gold pieces?
I don't know. I have to think about that.
Hold on, let me go see how much what I am looking at costs.
Yeah.
I just, what I'm looking to do is sheath this. I'll pull out my big old hefty greatsword so I don't have to carry it around in my pack all the time. Especially because it lights on fire. And we're going to get a boat.
The hunters that are sitting at a table about 5 feet from you guys as you're having this conversation say, we have some furs if you want them.
They're
cool.
Gold.
How much? Gold? Can I borrow it? Oh, I'll just give them the gold.
Alright. They hand you some fur pelts.
Cool. I'm just going to
from
kinda,
a deer. Very soft
gonna,
leather.
Do I have any, like, like
will those help
like
keep
ties?
Us warm on the boat? Like, how long are we going to be on this boat in a blizzard?
You're not sure.
Will we be inside?
Yeah, well, I'm sure
no.
they have, like, a lot of
okay, I'm going to go to
or,
the
like,
tent.
Okay. Leather workers?
Yes.
All right.
I'm going to be like, never mind. Hello.
Hi.
This is a bit of a strange request, but do you have any, like, leather strips?
Yeah.
It's for my leather
okay.
pants.
I'm gonna like pull out this big old sword and the furs and be like, is there any way that you could like tie this fur together and then like stitch a sort of sling for the scabbard?
Do you want me to just stitch the fur together?
Just stitch the fur together and then like a strap. So like that.
Yeah, I can do that.
Awesome.
Probably about 2 silver.
Cool. I'll give him 2 silver.
Alright. Should be done in about an hour.
Cool. Thanks.
Yeah. And fast forward time?
Yep,
sweet.
We good to do that?
Yeah, so I just go back to him and get the scabbard. And...
Yeah, it's fine. Okay. Like, it's not a great job, but
it will
do the job.
I was just looking for something that'll hold
my
sword, so...
It'll do the job,
it
basically.
It will get shit done.
It wraps the, like, sword, though. I always thought, like, a makeshift scabbard would be cool for a magic sword.
Alright.
Anyway.
Fast forwarding. You guys spend the time in the tavern. You guys buying drinks at all?
No. Right.
Not before getting on a boat.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was like, I'm gonna.
I'll probably get some food on my stomach just because I haven't been on a boat before. Or if I have. No, I've been on a boat. Have I been on a boat?
Given where you grew up, it wouldn't be that weird if you went, like, fishing a few times.
But, like, I probably haven't been sailing a lot.
Yeah, like, you haven't done multiple days of sailing as you expect or ahead of you.
Should we, like, can we buy rations at the. Because I feel like I only have 2 left. And if we don't know how long we're going to be on this boat, it would probably be a good idea so we don't starve.
You know what? That's a great idea. And if what if there's a mutiny? We don't want to run out of rations.
How many rations?
What if there's a mutiny?
We kill all the mutiners.
How much?
I have 3 days of rations.
I steal some.
I have 2.
How many rations are we getting each?
How much does a ration cost?
2 gold pieces.
Oh, wow.
I have
wait,
one.
Is it? Let me double check that.
I have 1 gold.
Like, that's an expensive ass ration.
Well, maybe it's.
Do I have weight and price backwards?
Maybe it's like from Lord of the Rings. It's like llama spread, or whatever it's called.
Llama spread.
Llama spread.
Yeah.
And spread made out of
I know what you're talking about, too.
I know.
But like,
where it's like super filling,
yeah.
So like one bite fills you up, and you can have like a shitload of it.
I'm down for something like that. Just take
it. Handy rations. Except for then all you need.
5 silver each, sorry. It was,
okay.
They weigh 2 pounds.
You were actually pretty close.
What?
Lambespread.
Yeah. I had to look it up. It was going to drive me nuts. Like, I grew you. Up watching this, yeah, so yeah. I couldn't just leave it be.
All right. So how many? It's five silver each.
Four.
Okay.
So that's what is it?
Two gold.
I'm so sorry.
Was five silver each.
Oh, okay.
I will give him a gold, and I'll take two rations.
Gives you two. It's like dried meats, dried fruits.
I'll take two rations as well.
All right, gold.
Okay. Okay, I'll take four rations and then do two gold so I can, like,
okay.
It's just more satisfying.
Good point, though.
All right. We done buying things?
Yes.
Okay. Fast forwarding.
Yay.
Tis evening.
Woohoo!
You guys go to the docks, find the Northern Owl.
Is that the name of the Northern
yes.
Owl?
I'm gonna ask Leather Pants Man's name.
You don't see him at the moment.
Oh.
Someone who seems... actually, make an insight check. Anyone who's interested in this man's rank.
We all roll.
18.
15.
18.
All right.
Wait. You two need to add your...
Oh, modifiers. Wait, what is it again?
Insight.
Insight. Sorry.
Wisdom, and then if you're proficient, you get to add more. So I actually have a
19. I got a
19
as well.
Okay.
17.
All right. Seems to be a first mate. He's helping you aboard. You're the three that's headed to Snowcastle, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is a long ship as well. So there are about 20 crew members.
Is it like one of those paddleboard ships where it's like at the bottom they row?
They typically row if they're not going to be using the sails. So like either in extreme winds or like if they're close to shore. But if you guys will be traveling for multiple days, it's going to mostly be sails.
Cool. Yeah.
But they still need people to rig. The sails and all.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool.
Where are our cabins?
You don't get a cabin on this boat.
You don't get shit. You sleep on the floor.
You just sleep on the floor.
Sleep on the lower decks.
I'm down with that. All
right.
Or if you want to sleep under the stars up here, just don't get in anyone's way.
Okay. Freezing your ass up.
And then I'm just gonna keep good track of my sword because it's kind of cool and I don't want someone to sleep.
All right.
I'm gonna sleep on the lower deck.
Don't find any potatoes. You do find some like heads of cabbage.
That works.
That you could snuggle up with. Get real.
That sounds
get
horrible.
Get real familiar with this cabbage.
I'm gonna get real familiar with that cabbage.
Wilson.
It's like Wilson.
Haven't seen that movie.
I haven't either, but I get
but,
the
like,
joke.
Everyone knows the reference. It's the thing.
I'm gonna snuggle up with those cabbages and
All right.
Keep an eye on them.
All right.
Where was I while I was pulling cabbage? Just make sure.
All right. You guys set sail about an hour after you guys get on.
Cool.
Anything you want to do on this ship?
Okay, how long are we gonna be on this ship?
Who are you asking?
The first mate.
To Snowcastle. If we were headed straight there, it would be a little over 4 days. We do need to make one stop on the way, so probably about five. We should be in that town for about
a
day.
Where are
we
stopping?
Do you remember what we need to tell the Divine Watch?
It was about the occult, right? And the three items that we saw in our hallucination.
Yes, sir.
We're stopping in Carran. It's a few miles north of Snowcastle.
Is it like a big city or is it trading?
It's fairly large, much bigger than Snowfall, but not nearly the size of Silverkeep or Snowcastle.
So if we needed, we could grab rations.
Yeah, supplies. You can buy anything you reasonably need.
Okay.
Could I sell this leg?
If you find the right necromancer, I'm sure you could.
Can I just like grab that leg or grab the leg and chuck it in the like? Oh.
No, my leg! I'm gonna stab you if you do that.
Okay, contested athletics.
I'm just
athletics
no. I, okay,
or
hold on. Before that, I'm gonna be like, throw away that leg.
No.
Can I do intimidation?
I'm not gonna
throw
no.
Children's
please.
Can I do?
You can't roll against. each other unless it's like a physical thing.
Can I like, oh, okay. So I'm gonna be like, you need to throw away that light.
I'm not gonna throw away this light. You're gonna have to take
how
it
am I gonna intimidate
hands.
Her? Just be like, I will smite your ass with my fire sword if you don't throw away that leg.
You do it and I'm gonna kick your ass from the dead with this leg.
I can pick you up and drop you in the ocean with the leg.
I'm gonna keep it.
No one here wants to smite that leg. I'm gonna tell the crew member, like, this leg she's been keeping. It's weeks old. It's not physical. It's disgusting.
Believe me, I can smell it. I mean,
any
kind of
here?
Get used to
it's
the smell, though.
My fucking
it's not
job
that unusual.
To sell this leg. To someone, anyone, it doesn't matter.
Dan the Warlock will not miss that leg.
He
and
will
neither
not.
Will you.
I am going to miss it. He's my friend now.
You do not need Wilson the leg.
I need Wilson!
Throw away the leg, please.
He's the only one that loves me!
Throw away the leg!
I'm not gonna throw
Dan?
Away his leg.
Huh?
Do you know Dan's last name? I knew a Dan once. Went missing about 3 weeks ago.
Was really? He a crazy cultist?
Was he good at magic?
No.
Like,
to
oh,
either
I'm not
of
just,
those?
No.
Can you describe what he looked like?
Oh! Dan was possessed! Dan the Warlock was possessed! He wasn't a Warlock!
I'm
not
for nothing.
Oh!
I'm still
yeah, we ran into a it's a little bit of a long story. I'll tell you once we set sail.
I mean, you guys are sailing at this point.
Yeah, we're on the road.
Just kidding.
We're on the road.
JK.
Alright,
on the road again.
I can't wait to be all right. On the road again.
I'll tell you the story if we can just get rid of that leg.
I'm not gonna do it.
I can smell it.
I
can smell it
if I
from across
it
the
with
town.
Salt, will you leave me a little bit?
There's no preserving it anymore. It's like decomposing.
You know what? How about I just take all the flesh off?
How about you just throw it away?
No, I'm keeping the bones at least.
Here, let me at least try and preserve it.
Do I trust him?
Do you?
Do I?
Make...
I'll get.
Hold on. If you're telling the truth, roll a persuasion. If you're not,
well,
roll
hold
a deception.
On. I'm gonna be like, okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna burn off the flesh.
With your sword?
It's gonna smell like shit, but it already smells like shit.
It already smells like shit, it might as well just smell like more shit. You better not light my bone leg on fire.
I'm gonna light the leg on fire, and then I'll get rid of the flesh, but it'll leave the bones there.
You better leave the bones there. I'm gonna sell these bones.
First of all, maybe don't do that on a boat.
Just kidding. Just throw away the leg. You don't know how to preserve a leg. Just throw away the leg.
I've had it for this long. I can't get rid of it now. It's a part of me.
It's a leg.
It's my leg.
It's not. It's Dan's leg. And you took it.
You know what? It was blown off. It was finders keepers.
Do I get a say because I blew
rules
off?
Those are the I have heard. If you find a leg in the wilderness, it is your leg.
What if I'm the one who blew off the leg?
Can you still see the person that it used to be attached to?
Yes.
Probably their leg, then. If you find it, like, out in the middle of nowhere with no one around, it's your leg.
But if I took the leg?
It's not your leg.
Well, what if I give it back to Dan one day?
These are the rules I've heard. This is all the first mate talking.
I'm gonna be like, if you toss it in the ocean, it might find him one day. It's your best bet. Toss it in the ocean.
Do you think I'm stupid?
Toss it now! Toss it in the ocean!
No,
toss the leg in the ocean!
Leg,
toss
I'm
the
not
leg in
leg.
The ocean!
I'm
toss
not,
it now!
I'm
toss the leg.
You have to take me, toss it.
Okay, I'm gonna grab the leg and toss it in the
I
ocean.
Oh no!
Athletics check versus athletics or acrobatics.
Cool, I'm.
Roll off!
Okay.
Go!
Roll off!
17! The leg is mine!
Well,
you do not manage to snag this leg.
Throw away the
like
leg!
She just like ran away with it, like huddling this leg, like, no!
I'm holding in my teeth.
Everyone on this
leg.
Boat is gonna hate you because the boat smells like leg.
You're like decomposing leg.
Decomposing flesh isn't a weird thing on boats.
It's a leg.
Yeah.
You've dealt with people's decomposing legs?
Yeah. I mean, usually they're attached to the person, but...
Ugh.
I mean, at that point, you just cut it off.
Can I have those legs?
I pray to her
no.
I never have to smell another
kind
of decomposing leg.
You kind of take those ashore and burn them as soon as we find a proper place for them.
Damn.
Right. We have been known to sell them to the occasional necromancer, though.
How much do legs usually go for,
yeah,
then?
If you find the right necromancer, you could get about 5 gold out of a good one.
Do you think you
that's
can...
you're hauling a decomposed leg across the ocean
decomposing
for $5?
One is usually
listen to me.
Going. Give her $5 and maybe she'll throw it.
That decomposing though is probably
here,
gonna
I have
like,
5 silver. I'm broke.
You know what? Listen to this. If we give this to a necromancer, do you think he could tell us at one point if this leg was possessed by somebody or by something?
No. Because it's going
to
be bones.
So what? Necromancers deal with bones. That's what their thing
necromancers
is.
Reanimate bones. They don't know what the hell happened to the bones.
I'm sure you look at a bone and you're like, man, that bone was stabbed.
Okay, but you're not like, man, that bone looks like it's seen its host of demonic
you know what? Well,
it's
knows?
A bone. Just throw away the bone.
You know what? If I have like a mark on it as a demon, he's like, whoa, this has been possessed by
listen,
a demon.
We're sailing
maybe
and it's
if you
night.
Find a diviner. Not a necromancer,
we're
but a
sailing,
diviner.
And it's night.
Do you could think I could hand the diviner?
We are sailing.
Like,
we are sailing. And it's night, and the Divine Watch has already seen the leg when it had seen better days. Just throw away the leg!
No, I have to keep it.
And the Divine Watch is not the same as Diviners.
What
Diviners are a type of wizard who
casts
divination magic. Divine refers to holy magic.
I could give it to a diviner.
How long has this argument been going?
A long time.
It's like probably late at night. Like people are probably going to sleep. But
no,
I can't sleep when
I mean,
smell that
leg. There are a few other
leg.
Passengers
you know
on this boat as well.
I will leave the leg somewhere else where it is not
ones.
In the vicinity of your fat ass nose.
Can I try again for a
No.
Can I like more aggressively?
Yeah. No.
You stab her.
You do that,
you've
I'm gonna pull out
tried.
A knife and cut your arm.
I don't want to fight, but I don't want to smell leg. It's a leg. You don't need it. It's a
I
leg.
Need, you have no idea how much I need this leg.
The circlet on your head is worth more than the leg.
It's a lot more.
It doesn't matter. This leg is my leg.
Okay.
Can you pretend the circlet is your leg and throw away the leg?
You know what? I saw this leg from the beginning of its making to now when it was blown up.
It's a leg.
It's my leg.
And you didn't see when it was made because it was made 20
saw,
years ago when
I
Dan the Warlock was
you know
conceived. By
assuming
his,
he was 20.
Right. Leg. Assuming.
Okay. By
you know
his
what?
Leg.
I saw this
parents.
Leg of its detached form into being when I took it.
Put away. The most interesting thing it had was the little like blast marks from Marilyn's leg
how
blast.
How about I just cut the meat off and throw it into the ocean?
Now the bone smells like ass. Just throw it away.
You
don't want to
wash out bone. You
we fade to black. This argument carries on into the night.
By the end of morning, we're just crying, just like, you can't take it from me.
Because in the morning, when you both wake up, you've passed out, like, on opposite ends of the ship, just kind of leaning against the railings.
And everyone's on my end, because that end smells like shit.
Doesn't seem to bother most of the sailors. Some of the passengers are definitely bothered. But
I'm gonna, she's
I'm
like watching the
okay,
leg, right?
Listen, I'm not a man of many words, but I'm gonna start going to the passengers and being like, you think that leg is a problem, right?
You think this is disgusting.
Mutiny!
We're still arguing about this leg and like...
Oh no, I'm not talking to you right now.
Me and you are not friends right now. The next
the
town, I will get rid
oh,
of the
it's not that. It's not that we're not friends. I just don't want to deal with this leg. I'm really tired of it.
You know what?
It smells like leg.
At the next town, I will get rid of this leg, I swear to God.
That's like most of this trip.
That's fine. I just get to hold on to it for a little bit longer.
Okay, I'm gonna be talking this passenger.
Yeah.
How's your leg?
I think that leg
that's
is
great,
a problem,
thank you
right?
for asking. It's my child. My disembodied
roll a d20 for me.
You're gonna start a mutiny, JJ. We're not gonna get to our destination.
A hard three. You're really
it smells bad, but I've smelled worse.
Damn it.
That guy you're talking to says.
Damn it to her die.
Just like the
guy.
Boat suddenly bursts into flames.
God's fucking damn it.
Fuck it.
I'm gonna go to another passenger.
Dude, this leg
they seem to agree with you. The most of the rest of them seem to agree with you, but like they're not really.
Listen, I want this to be a peaceful place.
They're like.
But we need to find a way. We need to find a way. Steal this leg. And get it into the ocean.
They kind of like look over at her.
What?
Seems feisty.
She's
I've,
good at
I've,
stealing.
I've,
but
okay.
If we steal it from her before she notices, she
I mean,
won't know. I don't steal. So
I mean, I'd rather not risk it.
I'd rather not be stabbed.
I'm gonna go to another braver looking.
That's what most of them say.
You can ask a sailor to do it for you if they're willing to be stabbed.
You'd be like, which is worse, a terrible smelling boat, or the fact that you took a leg from a criminal and threw it into the ocean?
Man, stealing things from criminals tends to get you stabbed, so.
But what if
or worse.
I can defend you.
They always find out one way or another.
Baskin and Robbins always finds out.
Baskin
and
Robbins.
Wait, are you gonna bring up that thing again? It's okay.
Ant-Man was almost written by Edgar Wright. Like, it was part of it, at least.
Yeah. Have you seen that trailer where it's like, ants!
No.
Ants!
I don't watch trailers anymore.
I know, but
they spoil the movie.
Oh, no, this trailer's wonderful. Like, I'll send it to you.
Trailers spoil the movies now.
They do, yeah.
Literally, like...
Or they're deceiving and, like, they show things
right?
that aren't in the movie.
Okay.
Okay, this is a tangent. I'm going to defend... No.
Very small tangent, JJ. It'll be fine.
Make it small, Jack.
The beautiful world.
Jack, come back.
What's the new Star Wars movie called? Like, Final Skywalker
Rise
or whatever?
Rise of the Sky... Yes.
Whatever that is.
Is it Skywalker?
Anyway, it's something Skywalker.
Something of the Skywalker.
Yeah, anyway.
Rise of the Skywalker.
Watch the first trailer. What's the trailer's primary duty?
It's...
To get you excited about the movie, right?
Yeah.
I wasn't excited by that trailer. It's like, okay, Rey's standing in a desert, and she jumps over a TIE interceptor or whatever. I'm not good enough with Star Wars anymore to know the distinctions. But it's like, you see that in, like, every action movie. I don't, like, the lightsaber doesn't give me an erection anymore, you know?
It no longer makes me hard for Star Wars.
Like, it's cool, but, like,
we've
seen
lightsaber
in 8 movies, not counting, like, the side ones.
Well, I mean, I think the reason that Disney is making these movies is
because they're a cash cow.
Yeah.
I don't think they're illegal. Anyway.
Who would guess?
But like...
Disney?
No!
Disney!
Cash cow?
They have so
never.
Much money. I don't know why.
They own everything.
They own everything.
Thinking
nothing
Disney,
is sacred.
Can I go on another tangent?
And Amazon.
Like,
how long?
It's not very long.
Sure.
That whole, like, you know, they're making Ariel, like, they're live action Ariel.
Yeah.
The whole Not My Ariel live thing, action. That's fucking garbage.
I think
who
that's really dumb.
Who gives a shit if Ariel is black, white, blonde,
she's
red-haired.
Literally a fictional character
right.
from the ocean.
And okay,
she can be fucking blue.
I think it's totally cool. Like,
right, I don't care.
I just don't pay attention to it because I don't care about the live action.
Right.
I just saw
animation
it.
Is amazing.
Animation is so cool.
Like,
right.
it can do
Love
so
it.
Many things that live action just
okay.
Right.
CGI and tribe.
No.
Never seen.
It's anime. It's CGI.
I totally agree with it. But, like...
It's not live action.
Not live
but, like, the problem is...
It's expensive animation.
Okay. This tangent is going longer than
okay.
expected.
Yeah.
But, like, the thing with that is they try to make it look realistic. That was not the goal of the animated movies.
No.
It's not.
But, like...
The whole point was
look
kind of
at Lion... Like, watch Lion King, turn off all the lights before the movie starts, hit play, and that opening scene... I'm thinking about it and it's giving me chills.
It's good.
Like,
it's amazing. Like,
the
colors.
And Aladdin is the same way. It opens in, like, the desert.
In, like,
and
the bluish,
so
like, violet
red
sky.
And, oh my god.
I believe
so
things should be.
The contrast is beautiful,
totally
especially in that movie.
Like, they reanimated a lot of these movies. They probably look fucking awesome. But my thing is, with black
just,
Ariel and people getting pissed because she's black, mermaids existed, they would not only be black, they would be fat, so they could live under the ocean and have enough body fat to keep themselves warm.
Quick thing about that,
all
though,
you people.
Like, I feel like anyone who's, like, upset that Ariel is black is, like, not doing it, because Ariel's not the same. Like, that's kind of a weird thing to be upset about.
Right, I can see the Mulan thing where they're not adding Mushu, that's garbage.
Oh, that's garbage.
It's
that's
garbage.
Bullshit. Mushu was the whole movie.
It was.
It shouldn't be
great.
Called Mulan. It should be called Mushulon.
Mushulon.
Mulan
has
the
such
subject.
A better ring to it. Mushulon.
But no, I
Michelin
think that's
Man,
garbage.
The
but
movie.
The Black Ariel thing, that's bullshit. You're all crybabies. Get over it.
I don't. I all don't right. A lot of people.
Tangent over.
Yeah.
We need to get back on track.
We're good on our Disney tangents.
All right. Okay. So, you guys sail on.
Cool. Can we see him again?
No. Does anyone want to inquire about any of these crew members' names?
I would love to get to know the crew members.
Okay.
Because if I have
I only have names of two of them, so you get to name all of the rest of them as you recollect about them.
Yay!
In future.
That's cool. A powerful, like, thing to give her.
Your name is Buttflap. At least that's his nickname.
It's an honorable surname, I will have you know.
Is it spelled like B-U-H-T-F-L-A-U-P?
No, it's B-U-T-E with an accent. F-L-P-H.
F-L-A-P-H.
Yeah, but the Butt H flap. Is silent.
You say it, Buttflap.
Hey, Buttflap, what's going on?
Everyone calls him Buttflap, but it's pronounced Bootflap.
No, it's pronounced Bootflap.
No one can pronounce it, so it's just Buttflap. Hey, Buttflap.
It's like right. Shatine.
First mate's captain and first mate's names are Andy Wainwright and Andy Cartwright.
Are they brothers or something?
No, nothing. My two hot fuzzy people. Come
yeah,
on.
They're hot fuzzing the shit out of us. We don't do.
They're the Andes.
Oh, yeah. Lord.
Jesus.
Andy Wainwright and Andy Cartwright.
Are you proud of yourself?
Yes. All right.
Hot
fuzz reference over.
Great.
Still their names.
How many hot fuzz have we
okay.
done this?
Two.
Two.
So we've had so many tangents.
We've had.
This isn't a tangent.
You know what? This is just fun.
This is his name.
I want to protect this people.
All right.
Can I name at least one more crewmate?
Try.
You can name all of them. That's what Jack said.
Yes.
Yep. All you right, have 17 more to go.
Oh shit! We got Buttflap.
I expect a text at midnight tonight, being like, "This is all their names."
This is all of their names. In alphabetical order. Alright, we got Buttflap.
We need to have one for every letter.
Meat shield.
Meat man. She just keeps, like, repeating it until she gets a laugh. Like, oh, guys.
You guys land in Carran after about 2 days of sailing.
Did I get seasick at all?
With the leg, maybe.
I shoved it
yeah,
in your
nose.
Yeah,
with the leg, yes.
Like,
part of it is like the like very rough, choppy waters.
So we're at the next town, right?
But yes. Like,
I grab
you
the
have
leg
been
and just
puking.
Like chuck it over.
I'm gonna go sell.
Athletics,
I don't care. No, like, are
we
no,
fighting
like,
again?
I'm gonna fight
yes,
you, right.
You guys
Jack,
get
Jack,
one more.
No,
roll.
Jack. I'm doing this like in the middle of the night.
Okay.
I am tired of this shit. Like,
okay.
Like,
make a stealth check. Make a
can
perception
I just,
check with disadvantage because you are asleep.
Fuck. Can I wake up to watch this? Because, like, I'm very sensitive
you...
to sound.
Oh.
I just want to see what happens.
Oh, my
with,
God!
With,
this place is going to hell.
With disadvantage, Maddie,
okay.
Roll twice, take the lowest.
I got a 5, so you're not going to do worse.
Okay. You immediately wake, like, he just steps on a floor, like, on a board that creaks a bit too much. You immediately wake up, like, dagger pulled.
Can I just grab the leg really quick and just throw it overboard?
Like,
I am so sick of this
leg.
Okay.
Oh, yeah,
so,
we need to.
Make an athletics check, make an ac- are you protecting the leg, or are you going to stab him?
Oh, I'm gonna protect it.
Okay, make an acrobatics or athletics check.
I'm gonna get harder than 13. Oh no, God, please, if you love me and my leg, you're gonna do it.
I pray for you.
What's that?
I got a 15.
Want to add your stuff?
No, hold on. You said athletics or acrobatics?
Either. Whichever you would prefer.
Let's do an acrobatics, which is a plus 5.
Okay.
Damn it, I got an
18. Yeah, unnatural 20.
Alright, so. You go to, like, grab the leg. She, like, nicks your hand with her knife and kind of, like, curls over the leg.
It's my
precious.
I'm just gonna go slink back to my bed and go back to sleep.
You're gonna, like, get an infection.
Which deck are you sleeping on?
Mine?
Which deck, though? Like, I'm asking you what deck you chose to sleep on.
Upper.
Okay.
You're not gonna sleep with me.
So the main deck?
Cabbage.
Alright.
Because I want to be able to see land.
Okay.
I probably look like a goblin.
Yeah, you're like a leg goblin.
The night before you guys land in Carran is when you guys get out of this blizzard. The seas calm down a bit.
Is it nice on you, Will?
No.
Bullshit.
It is still gray and cold and miserable.
So how many days were we on this boat?
So far, two.
So do we need to eat rations, right?
Yes, two rations down. And you guys have ran out of water after the first day, but these sailors were kind enough to share their booze with you.
Oh, sweet.
Yay!
It's pretty watered down because they're not trying to get drunk. It just tends to be healthier than water, especially if you're keeping it in one place for extended periods of time. Which they are.
So it's like shitty-ass beer.
Pretty much, yeah.
I was just thinking it was like more alcoholic water.
Or barley water.
Basically. It's like a Mike's Hard Lemonade, except water flavored.
At least Mike's Hard Lemonade is like a 3.2 rating.
Okay.
Alright. You guys land in Carran. It is morning. The sun's up. It's still very overcast, though.
I just want to be where the woman is. I'm gonna get off the boat. I'm gonna take my freaking leg with me.
Alright.
Is that all?
Yeah.
And are you just like standing on the docks with your leg?
I'm holding it like a child.
Push her in the water with it.
I'm gonna get steady.
I'm gonna like reach for them like tempted, but I'm just gonna stop and go.
You're like, if I had the 42 in my ass.
Yes.
Alright, what are you two doing? I'm standing on the dock with my
darn
leg
chewing.
Baby.
Yeah. What are you two doing?
I'm gonna go into town to see if I can get just another two rations, just in case.
Okay.
See what other shops there are.
I'll go explore around. I don't really have any money, but...
Alright. You
find... Do you
wanna
come with me?
Sure.
You find a general store. They have rations for you. 5 silver each.
Okay. Do you need rations, Rangrim?
Yes, I do.
Okay. So I'll do 4. I'll give him 2 and me 2.
Okay.
Thank you.
2 gold.
I still have 2 sets of
rations. And before you guys got off the ship, the Captain Andy Wainwright, told you guys that you would be leaving later tonight and be at the docks by sunset again.
Okay, but now it's not as hard to see the sun. Like, it's still overcast, but...
You can definitely tell when sunset is, though.
Okay.
You guys would guess you have about 3 hours ashore.
Awesome. I'll go check out some other shops, see what they have here.
I want to look for suspicious characters of any kind of sword or shape.
Make a perception check.
I got a 9.
Is that with modifiers?
No.
Thank you.
Perception with modifiers. There we go. It's 5. Alright. 9, 10, 11, 12,
13, 14, 15.
You know what? I'm
6. After 1.
Alright. I mean, you are very small.
Hey.
So.
No, I'm not
6
after that. I wish I was.
No, but you're halfway
my
feet.
Yeah,
off of your like spiced water.
I'm just pouring like something into you, like, what the fuck is that?
You find some
I like my
you find some people standing in the shade, but no shady people.
Damn.
That's the
I forgot to change my modifiers because you put it as 3.
Mm.
I hate my
life. I have a skill where you can read like thieves' language.
Thieves' camp?
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you look for any of that anywhere here? I know it's not a large town.
Sure. Make a investigation check.
Yeah. That's a 13. And then plus my perception.
Investigation.
Oh, investigation. Is plus 1, so that's a 14.
You find some around. Nothing like... Well, what are you looking for? Specifically.
Like a black market?
Black market merchants.
You find quite a few of that type of stuff around. It says, head over to the waterfall.
Alright, I'm
in general walk around and ask anyone if they know what waterfall is, like if it's a tavern, shop, location.
Who are you asking?
Just someone off the street.
So like a normal person, like a civilian, or there are some like armed guards walking around.
Just a civilian.
Okay.
Just like, hey, do you know what waterfall is or where I can find it?
Make a just general charisma check.
No. Oh shit. Let's see what my charisma is. I got a 3, so 7, 8, 9, 10.
They're not gonna be saying anything about the waterfall. They say they have no idea what you're talking about.
Bucket. Okay.
Bucket.
Bucket.
Alright. Looking for shops?
Yeah. I'm looking for shops of my own.
Okay. So, large town, you can find pretty much anything you want, including some, like, more mundane magical items in shops.
Okay. I don't have any money, but...
You can at least look.
Yeah.
There are quite a few taverns about, some inns, a few brothels.
I was gonna go look at armor.
Okay. Head over to a blacksmith's? Mm-hmm. Or an armory?
Armorer.
Okay. Head over to an armory. There is a dwarf inside. This is... Hey, how can I help?
Hello. I just came to browse some armors.
Right? What are you looking for, specifically?
Something heavy.
Plate, splint, ring, chain.
What's plate gonna run me?
Plate? Depends on what you want. The average is about 1,500 gold.
Mm. Alright.
We've got some nicer sets if you're in the mood for something a bit, you know, more glamorous.
Rangrim with his 5 silver.
He's like, I can afford that.
I should start doing the player voice. I'm not much for money, but...
Mm.
If ever I'm back in Cotton,
right? What did you say the name of this town was?
Carran.
It's Carran, but close. Most of the holds are saved for dwarven cities. Kind of like holds. But, yeah. Carran. Where are you from? You from here?
I am from... Let me check the name. I don't remember what it's called.
By the way, now that I'm thinking of this, I also...
I'll just say I grew up in the Quiet Hills.
Oh, yeah, the little dwarven settlement over there.
Yeah.
Nice. What's that been like? I haven't been there in quite a long time.
It's a bit of a long story. I didn't have the best experience there, but, lots of stonework.
So you were born there?
Yeah.
Nice. Only visited myself born here, but heard it's a nice place. And between you and me, they have much better ale. It's a bit shite over here.
They're serving water here.
Ooh. Fuck, I know, man. I... Stuff shite.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I want to just let you know I got
a... You find a tavern by the name of Waterfall.
Perfect. I'm just going to hang out there.
You going to go inside? You try the door. It seems to be locked. Someone slides open a little metal eye thing. Looks outside. Damn kids again. Slides and closed.
What the hell?
Hello, you assholes.
I am here to make business.
Slides them open. Maybe step back a bit. Can't see you.
You bitch.
There are no windows to this tavern as well. which is weird. Even
are you just gonna
north.
Pull yourself up?
I just wanna like grab the fucking thing. Like, just like
Vanny's just
so
turning
you, like
a
grab
goblin
into the like eye.
Yeah, just.
Well, if you're gonna do that, slides the thing closed,
no,
jamming your
no.
fingers in.
That's sad.
Why didn't I pull out any? I pulled out dice. Where are they? They're here. Ha! You take two damage as this slides.
Rude.
Yeah, no. Alright. At least I can tell him I have something to sell.
Are you just calling through the door?
Like, bitch!
Bitch, I got shit to sell! No, I'm just like, hey, I got wares.
What exactly? Doesn't open the thing again.
You'll have to see for yourself, my man.
It's a leg. It smells like ass. He probably thinks you're like some necromancer's thrall.
But I'm gonna do something.
Well, if you can't tell me, you can't sell it here. I'd look elsewhere.
How about a demon-infused leg?
What?
You heard me.
Yes! Doesn't mean I understood. The fuck does that mean?
I had to get over that thing first. It's a leg that had a demon in it.
What? Like a demon lord? Or like one of the lesser, like just a demon?
You are like
scamming this man. No
sell
idea
it.
What
or
happened.
Or like, are you a bit confused and is it a devil? Some people get those confused.
It's a demon. It's not a demon lord.
So just a normal demon. I'm someone who might be interested.
It's just slides gonna be a normal the, leg. Scam
slides
will
the
never
thing
be
open
able to come
again.
Back.
What's the password?
No.
Are you just gonna like be like, leg?
Can I just hold it up like it's some treasure? I'm like, leg.
Slides the thing closed.
No.
Wrong answer, and you only get one try.
Oh shit! Well,
for a visual aid, what we did was like we like bowed our head very low and like raised our arms.
Like we were presenting a sword
like we were
to
presenting
a dark
a sword
lord.
To a
Excalibur.
Dark lord.
Yeah,
like, she's like a leg.
Especially because it's like decomposing, like the flesh is like falling off.
Yeah.
It's like leg. Moving between my fingers, I'm like, leg. Angels sing at it and then throw up.
Angels are like, this just smells bad.
This shit sucks.
Marilyn, what are you up to?
Oh. So I went and got rations. I'm just gonna walk around, see if there's anything to buy. What kind of shops are there?
Basically anything you'd want, including some more minor magical items. There are some shops that actually
are
sell
there, like,
magical
crystal
items.
Yeah, like, I doubt it would be considered a magical item, but is there any place where, like, a potion shop where I could try and sell these flowers?
Yeah, there's a herbalist's.
Sweet. I'm gonna go talk to him.
Alright.
Herb.
Hello?
Herb.
Hi.
My name is Herb, the herbalist.
Perfect! I love it!
Herb.
Sorry.
It would have been better if he's like, my name's Basil, how can I help you?
My parents were real hippies.
Hi, my name's Parsley.
My name's Indica.
I don't know where it came from.
My name's Parsley, how can I, treat you?
I just heard you say herbalist.
Herbalist.
So his name is Herb.
Sweet.
Herb of the herbalist.
I came across these flowers, and they turned to air when they come in contact with water. Are they worth anything?
He opens up a book that seems to be filled with various types of plants and even a few animals, and he looks through. I have it right here. I just need to find it.
Okay.
I'm
like debating on just selling them all. Do
what?
I need them again?
Where's waterboarding? I at least want to. For reasons.
Just two?
Yeah.
What if you need those flowers to make a potion of water breathing? You might be able to sell those to them.
I have no training in potion making.
Those
you could
are
sell them to someone that could and buy the potions from them.
White bubble lilies.
Oh, sweet.
Cool.
How
big are these? Like quarter? I'm gonna say
they're about like a palm sized.
And we were just shoving them in our mouths? I thought they were so much smaller.
Oh, okay.
It's bloomed.
Okay.
Like, you're not. Like, that's not the, like, just the stem. Not stem, but, like, the bulb.
Okay.
Like, the petals extend out to be the size of your palm.
Okay.
Okay. I was like, Jesus, that's a lot to put in your mouth.
Yeah.
Sorry if I don't know flower terminology, but. So. Says. Could probably give. How many do you have, actually?
You want two, right?
Yeah, I want at least two.
Nine?
Yeah, I could do about 10 gold each.
Really? I might.
Oh.
About eight.
Oh, damn it. I'm sorry, I got all hyped about that.
No, he'll give you 10.
Sweet. Sure.
Alright.
So minus 9 flowers.
Yep.
That's 90 gold.
Plus 90 gold.
This man is going to be selling potions and water and
dying
for a dozen.
10 bucks, he just like jizzed his pants. He's like, yes, I've never seen these!
And I jizzed in my pants. God, what song is that?
Oh, it's my Pants by the Lonely Island.
Thank you. I was trying to remember the band name.
Oh, okay, I was going
to
say.
So I, was like, I knew exactly the name of the song, but like, you need to know the band as well.
You start writing this down in my notebook. Like, this is getting all messy.
You're messy. Look at my notes.
Look at your messy. Notes? I've Look seen your notes. They have notes. Six things on them.
Yep.
Your stats.
That's it.
Alright. So.
Is it like.
Anything else?
Is it like. Is this town called like Carran?
Carran.
Is that how it's spelled? Or is it
Carran?
Oh, it's not like spelled. Right, like
no. Carran. Like Carran. Carran.
Okay.
Except for with an E instead of an A and ran.
No, it's an A.
Oh, it is cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you for listening to Dice Quest. I'm JJ and I play Rangrim. You can find us on Twitter @QuestDice.